एक्सरसाइज नंबर टू क्वेश्चन नंबर वन आई एम डूइंग सॉल्व एंड हाउ टू अप्लाई दिस फॉर्मूला सो इन दिस प्रॉब्लम सो यू कैन सी इन माई चैनल सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू रीड द क्वेश्चन ओके सो नंबर वन श्वेता डिपॉजिट रुपीज 350 पर मंथ सो श्वेता डिपॉजिटेड 350 रुपीज इन हर बैंक अकाउंट ओके सो दिस इज द प्रिंसिपल दैट मीन्स पी दिस इज द पी एंड इन रिकरिंग डिपॉजिट अकाउंट फॉर वन ईयर्स सो दिस टाइम इज वन ईयर्स बट टाइम इज व्हेन यू अप्लाई दिस फॉर्मूला सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू कन्वर्ट द ईयर टू मंथ एंड आफ्टर दैट यू कैन अप्लाई दिस फॉर्मूला ओके And without converting the time, no, year to month. So if you apply this formula, so your math will be wrong. So that's why first of all you have to convert year to month, and after that you can apply this formula. But P, and some student is doing wrong. So which is the principle? He's taken wrong, maybe. So which is principle and which is maturity value? So you have to take the right value. Okay. So that's why you have to read the question. Two times or three times you have to read the question. After that, you have to determine which is given there and which is you have to determine and which is you have to find out. So first of all, you have to determine. After that, you can take the value and after that you have to utilize the formula. Then your math will be right. Otherwise, if you not read the question, no, and after that you are solving the problem. So I think your 50%. You can doing maybe your answer will be wrong I think but I'm not confirm but if you not two or three times you read the question no so first of all I'm request to you please before solve the question you have to read the two or three times the question and after that you have to solve the question so I'm doing the solve the question first of all Question number one, Shweta deposit 350 rupees per month in a recurring deposit account for 1 year at the rate of 8% per annum and find the amount she will receive at the time of maturity. Dekho ekhane, first of all, when you if you suppose this type of word if you're available in your question, so amount when you solve the banking problem no so if you what if you get the amount what is there so first of all you have to remember it if your amount is you have to find out the amount so you have to calculate the maturity amount okay so first of all you have to write the question you have to write the value right value so first of all in question that is available is there P is there okay so P how much is there P is 350 rupees okay and what is given there number 2 8% per annum this is the rate of interest so you can write R is equal to 8% per annum okay and what is given there 1 year so this is time but N is not time so you have to write N And when you write the N, so that time you have to convert the month. Or if the time is given in the units of month, so that time you should not convert the time. So, but here is not month, this is year. So, first of all, you have to convert the year to month. And after that, you have to put the value in the place of N. So, 1 in 12, that is 12 month. N is what is N? N is not time. N is the number of month. Okay. So already formula is in my corner of the in my page. So you can take this formula. Okay. So total interest formula is there. First of all, before apply the formula of maturity value. First of all, you have to find out the total interest. Okay, so I is equal to how much? So if you find out the I, so first of all, you have to write the formula. Okay, if you without write the formula, if you can directly you have put the value, no? So I think your math will be 30-40% chance your math will be calculation be wrong. So that's why I'm request to you, please, first of all you write the formula. So that means I is equal to P into N plus 1 by 2 into 12 into R by 100. Okay, so then if you write the value, so in how P, how much is there? 350 rupees. And N is how much? N is the 12, and N plus 1, that is will be it will be 13, because 12 plus 1, that is 13, and 2 into 12 into R by 100. R means how much there? R means 8%, so 8 by 100. So 10 you can cancel from numerator and denominator, and 12 you can cancel, and 2 4 are 8. So how much is there? 35, 13 and 4. So you have to multiply 35 into 13 into 4. So if you multiply 4, 13 are 52 and 35. So you have to multiply. So 5, 2 are 10, in hand 1, and 5, 5 are 25, and 5, 1, 26. So 260, and 3, 5, 3, 2 are 6, and 3, 5 are 15. Okay. So if you add it, then you get 12, 2 in hand 1, and 6, 8, so 1820 is the total interest for the whole period. But this is not your answer. You have to calculate the, find the total, find the amount she will receive at the time of maturity. So you have to calculate the maturity value. So what is the formula maturity value? So maturity value formula is the P into N plus I. Already I am already calculated what is the total interest. So and you have to put the value. P is 30 350, and N is 12, and I how much is there? 1820 rupees. So if you multiply 35 into 12, so you get 35 to 70, and 5 and 3, so it will be 7 0 7 5 12, 2 in hand 1 4, so 4200, and interest is 1820. So if you calculate the addition, no, then you get the answer 20 and 8 2 10, 0 in hand 1 1 2 1 1 2, and 2 and 4, if you add it, then you get 6020 rupees is the maturity. So it is the answer. So he received, as he will receive at the time of maturity, is 6020 rupees. Okay, this is the answer. Okay, next question. So question number two, what is there? So first of all, you have to read the question 2 or 3 times. So Saloni deposited 150 rupees per month and in a bank for 8 months. So this is the N, but if you suppose there is already unit is month is present, so you should not convert the unit. So first of all, N is how much is there? 8, and P is 150 rupees, and here is a you have to find out again same question number 2 and 1 is the same. So interest is there 8%, and 8% is there, P is there, N is how much is there? 8. So first of all, you have to write the P is how much? 150 rupees. 150 rupees. And R is how much? 8% per annum. And N is how much? N is equal to 8 months. Okay. So what is the formula of interest? I is equal to P into N plus 1 by 2 into 12 into R by 100. So you have to put the value. So P how much is there? 150 rupees, and N in how much? 8, and 8 are it will be 9 by 2 into 12 into 8 by 100, because 8% is interest. So 1010 is cancelled. So 2 4 are 8, 4 3 are 12. Okay, 2 2 cancel, and 3 5 are 15. So there is 5 8 9. You have to multiply 5, 8 and 9. Okay, and I sorry 5 to jar 10 so 2 4 jar 8 so 4 and 9 is only there okay 4 into 9 so it will be 36 okay 36 rupees at as the interest but this is not your answer you have to find out the maturity value is the deposited what is the what will be the maturity value so MB will be MB so MB will be M dot V what is the formula of MB P into N plus I okay so P how much 150 N is the N is 8 and total interest 36 so 8 15 is 120 and 10 you have to put there so plus 8 so then you get the 1208 is the maturity value okay so this is your answer number question number 4 question number 4 you have to read the question Sonia had a recurring deposit account in a bank and deposited rupees 600 per month for 2 and 1/2 years if the rate of interest was 10% per annum find the rate maturity value of his account okay so first of all you have to write the value here P how much is there first of all you have to determine what is you have to determine the question is asking in there so find the maturity value so that means you have to find out the MB if you calculate the MB no so before you have to calculate the total interest without interest you never calculate the MB okay so first of all you have to write the P so P how much is there P will be P is how much 600 rupees P is 600 rupees only okay and rate of interest how much is there 10% per annum okay and after that n is how much if you calculate the total interest so you have to know that p how much is there n is there if you are available p n and r then you easily calculate the total interest okay so n is how much n means 2.5 years but this is a year this is not month so you have to calculate you have to convert in month so 2 years 2 and 1/2 so 2 to 4 and 5/2 years and if you convert month so you have to multiply 12 so 2 6 12 so this is the 30 month so n is 30 month n M-O-N-T-H-S okay so again you have to apply the same formula P into N plus 1 by 2 into 12 into R by 100 okay so what is the value of P P is there 600 rupees into N how much is there N means 30 and N plus 1 will be 31 by 2 into 12 into R how much is there R is 10% 10/100 okay so 0000 cancel and 6 2 12 and 2 5 10 okay so and 2 15 30 so there will be 15 into 31 into 5 so 15 5 how much there 75 into 31 so if you multiply then you get 35 and 31 5 1 5 and 7 1 7 and 3 5 15 and 5 in hand 1 3 7 21 21 and 22 so then you get 5 12 by 2 in hand 1 2 1 3 and 2 so this is the total interest for whole period 2325 rupees okay but this is not our answer you have to calculate the maturity value of this account so you have to calculate the MB you have to apply the MB formula MV. So what is the MV formula? Same formula, P into N plus I. Okay, P into N is the total deposited money. So P, how much is there? P means 600 rupees, and time number of month is 30, and total interest is 2325 rupees. Okay, so if you multiply 3 8 6 3 18 and 000 is 10 and 20 30 and 2325, so you have to add it. No, 2 5 3 2 8 0 in hand 1 2 or 8 10 8 0 in hand 1 1 and 2. If you not able to add from this shortly, so you can use the side page. So then will be your math will be right. So this is the answer. Okay, so question number 4 is done, and question number 6, and question number 4 and 5 is same. Okay, before solve the code this question, so I request to you, question number 4 and 5 is same question, so you can easily solve the question number 5. If you understand the question number 4 step to step, so you can easily solve the question number 5. So next I'm going to solve the question number 6. So Hanif has a cumulative bank account bank and deposited 600 rupees per month for a period of 4 years. If he get 5,880 rupees as the to interest as the at the time of maturity, find the rate of interest. So in this question there is asking rate of interest you have to find out. Okay, so first of all you have to apply this formula, because what is available is there, what is given in there, principal is there. Okay, this is what is the, if he gets as interest, so this is total interest. Okay, so if you can determine that, you have to calculate the rate of interest. No, first of all you have to calculate the total interest in the terms of R, because R is not there, R is not available, so you have to determine the R. No, so first of all you have to calculate the total interest in the terms of R. So this is not principal. Hey, this is not a principal, this is interest. Okay, so you never apply this is not maturity value. So first of all you have to calculate the I. So I is the first of all you have to write the value. P is how much? P is how much is there? 600. P is how much? 600 rupees. And N is how much? N is the 4 years. That means 4 into 12. So 48 months. Okay, and R is not there. Now R you have to calculate. So first of all you have to write the, you have to calculate the total interest. So you have to write the formula, P into N into N plus 1 2 into 12 into R by 100. So you have to put the value. P is how much? 600 rupees. And N is how much? N is 48. So 48, and it will be 49 by 2 into 12 into R by 100. R how much is there? R is not there. R is you have to calculate. So first of all I am told you, no? So you have to calculate the total interest in the terms of R. So and 00 cancel. So 00 cancel, and 12 4 ja 48 and 2 2 ja 4. Okay, so 2 6 ja 12, so you have to multiply 6 2 into 49 into R. Okay, so but this is not our answer, this is the total interest, but total interest is also given there. So according to the problem ATP, that means according to the problem 6 into 2 into 49 into R is equal to 5880. Suppose if you calculate the value, no? So after that when you find out that R, no, that time will be your calculation will be very difficult. So that's why you never multiply the value. So without multiply the value, you have to keep you have to write in there. And after that, when you according to the problem, that time your answer calculation will be easy. So that's why you never calculate the value. Okay, multiply the value. So but some student you are telling that this is why not you are multiplied this value, because when you calculate the R, no, that time you can easily calculate the calculation. 5880 by 6 into 2 into 49. Okay, so first of all you have to divide the by 2, then you get 2 2 jar 4 and 2 9 jar 18. Okay, and 2 4 jar 8 0, 2 9 4 0. Again you have to divided by 3, 3 2 jar 6, 3 2 jar 6, and you have to 3 9 jar 27 and 3 8 jar 24. 3 9 jar 27, 2 and 4 24. 3 8 24, 0 you have can write there, and again you have to divide 3 3 9, no. So so first of all, if you divided this by 49, so you get the 20 no. So 49 to the 49 to the 98, so 98, so 49 to the 98 and 0 you can write in there. So 20, so 20 by 2, the 2 10 jar 20. So total interest will be, rate of interest will be 10%. So rate of interest will get 10%. The answer, this question is answer is done. So there is asking find the rate of interest, so our answer is right. Okay, question number 8. This is the last question in this video. So my student, please you can see the question step to step, then you can easily understand so how to solve the question. So Mr. Gupta open recurring deposit account in a bank. He deposited 2500 rupees per month for 2 years. So time is there and monthly installment is there. Okay, so at the time of maturity value, maturity he got the, oh, that means MB is also given there. Find the rate of total interest you have to find out, and after that you have to, next question, you have to find out the rate of interest. So first of all, so some student you can ask the question, how to without, there is that interest is not there. Without interest, how to calculate the total interest when your MB and principal is there and time is there? Say that time, how to calculate the total interest without interest? So I am going to solve this question. First of all, number one, so here is how much is there. Here P is equal to how much? 2500 rupees. 2500 rupees the principal. Okay, and R is not there. R you have to determine R. So next, N is how much? 4 years. N is how much? N is 2 years. Sorry, 2 years. So 2 into 12, because 1 year is equal to 12 months. So that's why 2 into 12, that is 24 month. This is the nth. Okay, N. And you have to first of all, my first question is there. You have to calculate the total interest. So total interest, and MB how much is there? MB is equal to 67500 rupees. Okay, so what is the formula of MB? MB equal to how much is there? MB equal to P into N plus I. So I is also not there, MB is there, and I you have to calculate, so I have to determine. Okay, so MB how much is there? MB equal to 67500 is equal to P how much? 2500 into N is how much? 24 month plus I. Okay, so if you calculate 67500, then if you multiply 24 and 25 and 24, then you get 425 and 50, then 006 and 600 and there is 20, So you have to put the 0 plus I. Okay. But therefore I is equal to how much is there? 67500 minus 6. Then total interest is how much is there? 7500 is the total interest. This is the one answer. Okay. And this and second answer will be the, you have to write the determine the rate of interest. So again say number same formula total interest formula, that means p into n plus 1 by 2 into 12 into r by 100. Okay, so total interest how much is that? 7500 rupees. And p how much? P is the 2500 rupees. And n how much is there? N means n how much is there? So n how much is there? N means for 24 months. N is 24 months. Then 24 and 24 into 25 by 2 into 12 into r by 100, because you have to determine the r. So after that 7500 and there is 2020, you can cancel, and 12 to the 24 and 2 cancel, so there is 25 into r. So please request to my student, you never multiply this value, then your calculation will be very easy. Then r will be 7500 by 25 into 25, so 25 3 is 35, then between 20, again you have divided 5 is 25 and 5 6 is 30 and 5 12 is 60, so 12% per annum. So to rate of interest, how much is there? Rate of interest is equal to 12% per annum. Okay, so this is my the second video, second video. Please subscribe and like my channel, then you get the more video, and this type of video you can help to the understand your very difficult question, and you can easily solve the question. So please subscribe, please, and like, and my and connect with my channel. So from Alim Math Blog. So every thank you very much. Okay, bye bye.